Hello Ace, this is RetroTK2 and welcome to this Unity tutorial. Today we're learning how to log to Unity's console. We have a bit of a paradox here Ace. We need knowledge of C# in order to fully understand console logging, but in order for me to teach you C#, we need to learn how to log to the console. I think the best way to teach you this is to use basic C# terminology and press on from there. This will be tricky Ace, but if you copy what I do, we should be fine. So let's get started. Open up Unity. I'm going to use the project from the Unity Bare Basics video. Feel free to download the channel files to get it, Ace. Double click the My Mono Behavior script and Mono Develop should open. To log to the console, we have to call a static method in the debug class. Type debug.log open bracket close bracket semicolon into the Mono Behavior start method. Write a message inside the log methods brackets. Just make sure it's in parentheses and on the same line, Ace. The start method is called once when the game starts. Pop back into Unity and make sure the script is attached to the game object. If you haven't got the console window open, click Window, Console from the top menu. With everything set, click the play button. This starts the game and our message is logged. You can see a 1 beside the message. This shows how many times the same message has logged. Deselect and Collapse will log the message normally and displays only one occurrence of the message. If you have Clear on Play selected, the console will automatically clear itself on startup. You can manually clear the console by pressing the clear button. With clear on play deselected, the console is not cleared automatically at start and 2 log messages can be seen. If I select the collapse button now, you can see a 2 beside the message. Okay, here I'll show you the real power of Unity. If I create a copy of our game object, you'll see that the My Mono Behavior component is attached to both. If I click play, the message is logged twice on start. Just to hammer this home Ace, if I create another copy of the game object, hit play, the message is logged 3 times. The standard way to log messages in C# is to use the methods write and writeLine in the console class. This is found in the system namespaces, but don't worry too much about that just yet. Unfortunately, these methods won't log to the Unity console, so we can't use them Ace. If I put a log call in the update method, head back into Unity and click play, you'll see the console gets flooded with the update message. The update method is called each frame Ace. We'll talk about this and other Unity methods in later videos. You can also log messages as warnings and errors Ace, by calling the log warning and log error methods. Now the log shows a different icon beside the message. From here you can filter the logs, warnings and errors by clicking the buttons in the top right corner of the console window. You can pause the game while it's running Ace and step through a single frame at a time using the buttons at the top. We can also pause the game when the console logs an error. If I select error pause and press play, the game hits the error log and immediately pauses. Here's a handy trick Ace, if you click on the log message, it should highlight the line where the log was called in code. This is great when you're debugging your game Ace. I hope this hasn't been too tough and you understood enough to get the concept Ace. Being able to log to the console should make learning C# a lot easier. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe Ace, let me know if there's something you don't understand. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com to tell me how you're getting on. Thank you for watching Ace, and I'll see you in the next video.